Now let's understand the power of story. So what is power? The story shows how other people see the world. Yes, okay, nice. So, and how do we use this story? So these are the few ways. So they let us see how another person's interpretation of events is different from our own and how it is the same. So basically stories are used for what? To persuade, to basically when you want to sell your ideas or like sell your products, we try to persuade the users. And similarly, we try to use stories to educate. And similarly, when we have something important to communicate, we again use story. Okay, so it is important because our brains are built to learn from stories, and inspiring stories can lead us to invest in a particular opportunity, and stories grab and maintain attention. It's all about the engagement. The better the story, the better the storytelling skills, the more the engagement will be. So you need to understand this. Okay, so we basically use storytelling to persuade, to educate, and to communicate our thoughts. And now let's understand the relationship of story in UX. So as a UX designer, a story serves to ground our work in a real context, right? So we'll understand that. So story helps keep users at the center of the work, for at the end, product will be used by the users. Okay, so whenever we are creating any artifacts or creating any product, so when we convert the requirement of the users in the form of stories, like product vision, business vision, and product goal, okay, roadmap, and so on. These are like again different ways of how to present the story or how what we use to present the story. So when we present this, so this really helps us understand or who the users are, and then keep those users at the center of our work, so that at the end the user experience is all about user, right? And it's called as user-centric design. So basically, when we keep the user at the center, we are able to like build a better product for them. So stories helps us to show a design concept or a new product in action, or connect a new idea to the initial spark. So show a design concept. So now suppose you have a new idea, and if you'll go and like just talk about that idea in front of an investor, he'll not pay attention. But if you convert that idea in a form of a good story, you'll see a difference. You'll see that people would be ready to hear or listen to your idea, listen to your presentation and or your story in that sense, and they might even invest or like whatever. So that's why like the stories are so powerful, and stories are a way of connecting what we know about users to the design process, even if they can't always be part of your team, right? So now suppose I was the one who went out, did the research, and then I converted this research or the insights from the research in some meaningful artifacts. Now these artifacts, if it's well crafted, I would be able to tell my story about the users to the other people involved in the product development and product design. So it really helps. One, understanding who the users are and then conveying what is the need and of the users, what they want and so on. And we use the storytelling or the stories to do that. So stories help us see the user experience more clearly. So once we have the right story, we are able to like see the requirement in a very clear way. So story of a target user or an existing user that you get to know about after research can help a lot in crafting great user experience. So we create a lot of artifacts. So I'll show you a full list of different artifacts that we create in the UX process. So new people don't get scared. So we'll talk about that in a workshop. So these are a few of the artifacts. So one is the user stories, then user journeys, contextual interview also we do, and then present that in different ways. This we conduct surveys. So persona we build, a design, the storyboard, user flow journey, information architecture, prototype, and every artifact that we're creating here, we're actually trying to tell a story. We try to share an experience and so on. So the better we get in this storytelling, the better our experiences and the final results or the final product will be, okay? So I talked about this five-stepped process. So that's basically the understand, define, ideate, execute, and validate. So let's see what happens. So these are the different things that we do in each stage. So when we are there, like as a UX designer, working as a UX designer, we try to do a lot of different things. to better understand the real challenge of the problem statement. And for that, we do a lot of different workshops, a lot of alignment workshops, where we define the real product vision, the business vision. And we also try to understand like who the users would be, will be for our product and so on. And in order to like, you know, understand more, we do a lot of the different things. That is basically, we do the research, and there are like different kind of research. That's basically quantitative research, qualitative research. And in the quantitative, we like go out and so basically we send surveys and we other like, you know, we make use of a lot of data to understand the real need, okay, the real problem. And parallelly, we also conduct a lot of other kind of research, and these are basically the qualitative research. In that, we actually do the interviews, we try to craft empathy map, we try to like basically create storyboards, like rough storyboards. We try also try to we ask the users to write their own diaries, and then ethnography studies are done. So a lot of different things are done. So okay, so that is basically the understanding. And in this case, when we are understanding, we basically become a receiver. And we also try to create the whole holistic view, or get the holistic view of the whole ecosystem. And then we define rough customer journey map. So this is what we do when we are doing or understanding the real problem. Similarly, when we have the understanding, we do the definition, or we define the outcome or the result, okay, or from the learnings. So we refine then the vision and the strategy. So basically we try to do the SWOT analysis, then we do a lot of others. Workshops, then we finalize or define our final business roadmap, product roadmap, though nothing is final in any of the stages, but we try to get some, you know, some roadmap, like good roadmap. And then we also try to create a lot of other artifacts. That's basically the persona, empathy map, task analysis, mental models, pain points, then user stories, journey mapping, experience mapping. And in order to like create the best, we try to basically use different techniques. And these are basically 5 W's and 1 H, or like we try to understand like the effects and the impact. Effect is basically how will the product or the solution help the users, and similarly how it will impact the business. And we try to also define the key performance metrics that would define the success of the product. Okay, everything good till now? Understanding?
Yeah.
Okay, so that's basically the second stage, define stage. And after we have defined everything, we basically start working or developing different ideas to create the final solution. That's basically solving the problem. So we do a lot of different ideation workshops, and then we come up with the ideas. Then we do dot voting to select the final idea. And once we have the idea, we do the next few or create the new artifacts, like the information architecture, then sketching, and then the screen flows, then the layouts, and so on. Okay, so that's what we do in the brainstorming sessions, or basically when finalizing the ideas and improving the ideas. And in this stage, we also try to use different methods to prioritize or understand what should become the part of the final product. So for that, we prioritize few features. And that, and in this model, in this stage, we use different models. That basically the Moscow prioritization model, BGC model, the ROI, Kano, and so on. Okay, so don't worry about these things, but just remember or understand that yes, there are like few models that we use to prioritize what should be there in the product, what should be developed, and what should not be developed. Okay, and how to create the roadmap or develop the roadmap of the product. And similarly, we also try to understand or do the planning. Okay, so once we have the understanding of like what should be part of the MVP, we then prioritize. And then once we have the prioritization, we actually go and define or design the screens. We start with the lo-fi design, that's low fidelity design. Then we create high fidelity designs, and then we also create prototype. And once we have this, we go out, do the testing. And testing, it's not that it's only done at the end. It could be done anywhere. Okay, so when you have a concept, you can go out and test with the user, even with the rough ideas, then with the rough sketches and wireframes, and then even with the high fidelity designs, and then the final prototype. So you can do the testing anytime in this process. But once everything is good, once everything is tested well, and people are okay with the features and the final product, what you do is you get it developed and then finally ship it to the market. So we do a lot of different things in this UX process when building or working on any product. Okay, so when working on different products and creating different artifacts, the better you are in storytelling, because everything is about telling, everything is about presentation. So the better you are, the better or easy it will become for you to, like, you know, present your ideas. Okay, so as a designer, we need to have that skill. Now, I talked about this, right? So this is the first stage. I talked about all these things. So in the first stage, we basically try to collect the inputs from the users. Okay, we do the research. And when doing the research, we are actually listening to the user's story and the business stories. And then in the define, we basically, what are doing is, we basically, when exploring user research and other information, so when exploring, researching, and then presenting, then we can use this storytelling, you know. Similarly, when doing the ideation, when they're like, we are like, for example, suppose they're like 7 people working on the same project, doing the ideation workshop. So the better you are in expressing your ideas or creating your, converting your ideas in the form of a good story, the better the chances are that yes, your idea will get selected. So craft that skill, develop that skill, hone that skill, okay? So stories can be part of UX activities when stimulating or experimenting with design ideas, okay, when presenting your ideas. Similarly, when you're executing your ideas, so here also you can use the skills. So crafting the skills, when crafting in a way that the experience itself should tell a story, okay? And last but not the least is the validate. And in this, what we do is, like, we try to basically test the user and then share the results. So once you have sharing the results, or when testing, so when you are able to tell the right story to the user, setting the context, like what this product is, how this product should be used or would be used, and so on, then you will get the right results. And once you have the right results, how do you present it and how do you use it? That's, again, it's a different thing, okay? So stories can be used in many ways in design. So let's see. So they help us gather and share information about users, tasks, and goals, right? Similarly, they can spark new design concepts. So when we are doing this ideation, or when we do this ideation workshop, we basically use the stories. And similarly, they are a way to share ideas and create a sense of shared purpose. Now, once I have told a story, once I tell a story, and now when everybody, like in my team, they understand that story, then what happens? We all get the context, right? We get the right context, and then we work towards a common goal. That is basically, it creates a sense of shared purpose, and they can even pursue it. I talked about this earlier. And similarly, they help us understand the world by giving us insight into people who are not just like us. So sometimes you might be working for people, creating a product for people who are not like you. Like, you might be a regular designer, right? A designer, but you might have to work on a product that's for the healthcare people. Now, you're not one from the healthcare, but you can, you know, like, learn from them. You can do the research and then craft their experience. So that's why this really helps us understand the world by giving us insight into people who are not just like us. Or basically, if you're working for some industry about which we don't have any understanding. So yes, this really helps, because by listening to the other people's story, you can understand their problem. You can understand their environment, their need, and so on. And they put a human face on analytic data. Sometimes, like, because this design is also called as data-driven design, or basically we use a lot of data to, you know, like, decide what should be used or how the design should be crafted and all, and so on. So when presenting that data, once we are able to convert that raw data in the form of a story, we can really improve and, you know, sell the ideas and all. So similarly, stories describe a context or situation. I already talked about it, you know, when I was talking. So initially, so when we are talking, set the context right. Okay, so stories not only describes a sequence of events, but they also provide insight into the reasons and motivations for those events. What is the need of the user? Only when we, as a researcher, when we are able to, when we listen to the user stories, we are able to understand. So by understanding, by listening to the users, we are able to understand the right, or create the right context, understand the right context, or the real need. Okay. Similarly, so what we do is, like, here is, like, we when understanding the story, we are doing the research, we create a lot of different artifacts. So some of them are mentioned here. So like we do ethnography study. When doing the ethnography study, presenting the results, we can again use storytelling to present that in the right way. Similarly, when we are doing the contextual interview, we can use storytelling, we can communicate everything in a nicer manner and describe everything properly and then get the right information from the user. And this can be done in the form of a story. Similarly, when we are creating a storyboard, that's flow of the events. There also we can use storytelling. Empathy map, yes, we are in one way or the other like representing or, you know, empathizing with the user. So again, we can use the storytelling here. Persona also, okay. And similarly, customer journey. So all these artifacts, you know, in one way or the other, makes use of the story or the storytelling. So why not like then improve ourselves and become a good storyteller? And then when we become a good storyteller, it will really help us become a good designer. So stories illustrate problems. So when doing the research and when we try to hear to the stories of the users, we try to understand that pain. We are able to understand that pain and the frustration and what they want. So it really helps in that, okay? And again, we try to use different or create different artifacts here. So basically we try to understand or create the notes, interview notes, then similarly empathy map, persona, surveys, data analysis report, customer journey. So a lot of different things we try to create to understand the real problems of the users. Okay. So if you don't know a few of these artifacts or the names or the terms, it's fine. Don't worry. Stories can help launch a new design discussion. So when you're there like telling or presenting your idea in the form of a new story, that might excite the other participants also. And they might get into the real design discussions. So that's why like it really helps in coming with new ideas. And these new ideas might define the direction of your product. So this is also very important, okay? Can generate new ideas. And we do a lot of different activities. We do a lot of design thinking workshops. So the future sessions, I'll talk about this also. So then we also like try to create a SWOT analysis or do the SWOT analysis. And we try also to create roadmap. Then we also like to do basically the stakeholder interviews, user interviews, solution blueprint, a lot of different things we do, okay? And when doing these things, this really helps us come up with new ideas and new discussions. So now since the stories are used to express the ideas and all, so it really helps in coming up with new ideas. So it's similar to like what I talked in the previous slide. So it's basically when there are a lot of people involved and like they have the ideas, and when everybody is presenting ideas in the form of stories and all, it really helps come up with real new ideas. So we do a lot of different things. When doing this big ideation workshop or sketchings, we might come up with new ideas, or even like when creating the storyboard, we might find a gap and then that could be like a good business opportunity. And similarly, when doing the information architecture, that could really help us, you know, understand like what should be or what is useful for the user and then plan accordingly. Similarly, user scenarios and wireframes. So stories can prescribe the result of a new design. So again, the same things, like we use different artifacts, and this really helps us understand the result of new design. So if there's some design, if there is some solution, and when you're out there like testing and all, so it can really help you understand like whether that went well or there were some problems. And by understanding this, you can really improve your product. So sometimes becoming a listener, sometimes becoming a storyteller, and that can really help you improve your product. Okay, so here, these stories can be more than just narratives. So adding context to action, providing an explanation for motivation or the goals during the behavior, user stories often focus on exploring those events. So they describe behavior and emotional attitudes, not just like what happened. I talked about this earlier, right? So basically, it's not just the sequence of the events, more to that. How you can add emotions, how you can give the human face to this story or add human elements to this story. So that can set the context or add more power to the story or the final solution. And few more slides, and these are basically stories engage the imagination. When you tell the story in the right way by using the right art of storytelling, so you're able to engage everybody, the audience. In our case, it's basically the users of the product. Okay, so a lot of different things we create here again. once we have right design guidelines, right design elements, or right story, if the usability is perfect, if the accessibility is correctly or accessible, the product is fully accessible, prototype is nice, or the final design is nice, people really love engaging. They will love engaging with your product. And I talked about this also. So basically, stories helps persuade. So it can help change people's mind. And we create different artifacts for that. And similarly, shared understanding, I talked about this also. Once you have the story, once everybody understands the story, they work towards a common goal. And so that is basically, we're done with story. Now, like few more slides and we'll be done with the session. So the next is basically skills of a good UX storyteller. So if you want to be a good storyteller, you need to have these skills. First, you should listen to people. You should be open to listening, okay? And then also be very good in observing. Okay, so like as a UX designer, sometimes go out for research and like we talk to the people. And when out there, listen to their problems. Be a good listener. Listen what they want from your product. And once you do that, you will see like, yes, your product will really start solving or meeting the needs of the users. And also be a good observer. When they're talking, observe them. See their emotions, facial emotions, the expressions, how they move their hands, how they move themselves, and so on. How emotional they are, and so on. So by observing, by listening to them, you can really improve your product. So careful, attentive listening has valuable benefits. It holds space open to allow other people to form their thoughts and express their mind, right? So the better you become in listening, so the more engaged the other person will be. And that really, really help you get the right insights. So when you really listen, you may hear or see things that surprise you, like emotional idea that you haven't considered in your design process yet. So again, a lot of new ideas can directly come from the users. You can hear not just what people are saying, but also the way they say it. The second layer can give you a deeper sense of who they are, what's important to them, and how they view the world. Again, it's all about observation. Observation is very important. Similarly, good work ethics is important. If you want to grow successfully as a UX designer, you need to have good work ethics. So storytelling has good research ethics, okay? So to be a good storyteller, you need honesty and authenticity. So it basically means that if you're out there doing the research, then present whatever you saw, whatever you heard. Don't try to change it and present in a colorful way. Don't do that. Never do that. Present everything in reality, in real. Okay. An honest story portrays user research accurately. Perfect. So good storyteller always presents everything accurately. And an authentic story is true to the feelings of the original events, right? And similarly, stories and storytelling are very powerful part of the human experience. So we need to be like very good or have good work ethics. And similarly, he's very good in collecting information, not just from one source, but from multiple sources. Okay. And he should be good in understanding or doing this ethnographic study, have a good understanding of like how to use qualitative mode or qualitative methods and quantitative methods, and good understanding of like primary research methods, secondary research methods, and so on. So he should be very good in collecting information. And how to write good stories or understand good stories or use storytellings. So these are the few points. So whenever talking, whenever presenting a story, keep the story as long as it needs to be, but no longer. Short and crisp, talk about the right things in the right way. Okay, keep the story crisp, have that power, okay? And don't let it get weighted down with unnecessary descriptions. Remove unnecessary descriptions, unnecessary details, and then use all tools of information design to share the way the story looks. And similarly, if using a story to share a detail about a user, just tell that story. Then don't make it a story about a story. So basically, share only the real details, but in an interesting way, and make the point of the story explicit. Tell it properly. Okay, so that is basically the storytelling, and that is what the designer should have, the skills, and how he can use the storytelling in crafting the real experiences. And that is basically by being a good observer, by being a good listener, and also by converting that insights in the form of a good story and then doing the right presentation. So that is what it'll take. And so this is the final takeaway. So basically, storytelling is how we share ideas and experiences. And having raw data is not enough to convince our teams and stakeholders of what needs to be done. A narrative makes a connection between our data and why other people should care about it. So it's all about presenting everything in the perfect way, in the nice way, so that the other people, they get engaged. Okay, so these are the different things that we should remember. Storytelling can help the help improve the overall product and experiences. And it, why it's important? Because it puts a human face on raw data. It can simplify complex ideas for a team. It's basically more efficient, helps in more efficient team collaboration and purpose. And it gives you real insights into the key users. And then also setting a project direction faster and experience delivers meaning and value to users. So overall is what? Overall, it really helps you improve the overall experience of the user. And you're able to achieve this how? By just presenting everything in the form of right stories, telling, creating the right experiences, and engaging the users, and so on. So by keeping storytelling at the heart of user experience, designer can create more engaging products. Cool. So that is what this session is all about. So it's all about storytelling. So these are a few books that I recommend you should read. So one is Storytelling for User Experience, and the other is Agile UX Storytelling. So read if you have time and learn more about storytelling. And that's it for the day. Okay. Thank you so much for joining. And I hope you enjoyed the session.